drop and started brewing.
What to do? How to drop all activities? Like this.
You are not even meditating actually. Don't focus, no concentrate. Just be in the inner space, which is consciousness God. Sarvadharman parityajya mamekam sharanam braja. Aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami masuchaha. All your vasanas will gradually disappear. Is it simple, Pradiva? Is it simple, Gayatri? So, practice until you are fully established in the Saguna Brahma state. Any questions, Ramani? Clear? You have to go now? How much time you have? Go. So then you come some day on Saturday and learn the rest of the practice which I am teaching. Okay, go. So I'll teach you, this is called Sahaja Samadhi. Sahaja because it's natural, there's no unnatural thing. Okay? Sahaja Samadhi will establish you more and more Shiva consciousness, which is Saguna Brahma. Okay? There's no effort involved, that's why it's called Sahaja. Samadhi means reality, which is Atma. Simple. Okay? By this practice what will happen, your vasanas will dissolve. No effort, effortlessly all vasanas will go. Impressions will go. Okay. So now I'll teach you one more practice called Soham Sadhana. Soham. Okay. This is actually Sahaja Samadhi or Koham Dhyana. Who am I? The question you have to ask is, who am I? There's no answer for who am I. So Ramana Maharshi taught, who am I? Find out who am I. You cannot find out who am I. There's a question without answer. So the moment you ask who am I, you will come back to the consciousness. Consciousness is not answer. Clear? No, who am I? One day I'll find out who am I? No. The answer is silence. Answer is consciousness. Answer is I am. Is clear, Vani? Okay. It's clear. So next, this is called Koham, who am I? Then other practice is called Soham. One is Shiva and other is Shakti. The counterpart. Okay? Shiva is silence, Shakti is movement. Shiva is related to space, Shakti is related to the body and breath. Right? So we'll do the counter practice called Shakti. Soham and Koham. Okay? So this is now Soham. I'm only teaching in this all throughout this course. Only two practice we'll do repeatedly. Okay? As you do practice, you will get more and more established in the divine consciousness. Okay? But for you to practice, you have to give time to this. Okay? And you start feeling divinity in everything which you do. So this is divinity in the manifest, Vyakta. Divinity in the unmanifest will go, some other practice. First you have to complete this. Clear? Surubana. ಅದ್ವೈತ ಸಮಾಧಿ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯ್ತಾ ಅದ್ವೈತ ಸಾಧನೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ದ್ವೈತ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಕಮ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಯು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಮೋರ್ ಇಮರ್ಸ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ನೆಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಸೊ ನೌ ವಿಲ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಅದರ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಸೋಹಮ್ ಸೋಹಮ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಅಸರ್ಷನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಯು ಹರ್ಡ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಸೋಹಮ್ ಜಪ ಸೋಹಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ In this Soham practice, you are not supposed to say Soham. Okay? So, just observe your breath. Take a deep breath and make a sound here. What does the sound come? Soham. In breath is Soham. Right? Soham. Are you clear? So who is doing the Soham sound? Your breath is doing the Soham sound. The breath is make the soha swaha. Okay? What is Pratishakti? Pratishakti. Shakti is saying soham. I am Shiva. Soham means Shivoham. What is Shiva? Consciousness. What is Shiva? You already seen. Consciousness. Right? Silence, peace, boundless space. Infinite. That's Shiva. Again and again, Shakti is saying, I am Shiva. Shakti is saying, I am Shiva. For whom is she saying? For whom is she saying? For whom she is saying? For the Jiva. For the kid, mother will teach her. Helpakanda, amma antilu, appa antilu. So mother teaches the child how to, what to talk. Shakti is constantly telling Jiva, say soham. Understand your soham, Shiva. Jiva is you. Now you have forgotten that you are Shivoham. So what you have become? You have become Ashwini. You have become Maitreyi. You have become Katyayini. You have become Ramani. Okay? So, you have become a Jiva, thinking that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. Now, who is telling you that you are Jiva? Who is telling you? Where is the programming happening? From the society. Everybody interacts with you, right? So, he asked, why I should not be in the Atma, this thing? The moment you get out of a meditation, your wife will call. Henry, kaafi bharti ro illo, then again you become a husband. Atma is gone now. Or you will start thinking, hey, nappa, no, ishto tar, kaafi kodbe kandu gottila irige. You have already become a husband. Have you remained Atma? Huh? So what has happened is, the more you interact with society, the more you are getting programmed that you are a body, mind and intellect, you are a Jiva. Right? Are you clear? Now you have to do deprogramming. Who will do the deprogramming? The mother, universal mother Shakti. She is telling you every time, soham. And 21,600 times she tells you. Birth is going in and out 21,600 times. Okay? 21,600 times she is reminding you that you are Shiva. So now which is stronger? The society programming is stronger or a mother telling you so stronger? which is dominant?
They are not concentrating on mother's
thing. They are not concentrating on mother.
They are not listening to mother.
So, which one is stronger? The pull of the society or pull of the mother? Push of the mother?
Society.
Society. Why society? First of all, you didn't know such mother existed.
Attention
is that your concept of mother is a statue where you are doing offering flower, doing namaskara, offering naivedyam and eating naivedyam. Right? Mother is your breath, mother is your life. Mother is every movement in your body, heartbeat, the thoughts, the emotions, everything is mother. Any movement is mother. Any silence is Shiva. Right? So, the question is, are you listening to the mother or are you listening to society? Naturally, you have to listen to society because you have to interact with society. But what you have to do, you have to learn how to come back to the mother. So, this is actually, that's why this is a practice which is a reminder for you to come back to Shivasthiti. It's clear? And you don't have to say soham. Again, it's effortless. Because any effort brings the ego. Okay, I am doing it. You see, that's why they teach japa. You would have to do japa 1,000,000 times. You know, I did 1,000,000 times japa. Okay? So here, the whole practice is become a non-doer. Don't do anything. That's called surrender. Okay? So, there is a teaching which actually say people, you have to do 24-hour japa. People keep on chanting. Okay, that creates a stress on the mind. Okay? So, this is no stress on the mind at all. Simply surrender the mind to the sound of the soham created by mother. Clear? So these two practices are practice of surrender. It's not a practice at all. It's effortless. That's why it's sahaja. Okay. Now there's a koham who is there. Here soham means shivoham. Is the teaching is there. Right? So shivoham, shiva you understood. Consciousness, silence, peace. Okay. So what you have to do here is you have to observe your belly. Okay. There's a belly movement you have to observe. Right? The belly starts going in and out. In and out. Is it clear? So what you're doing? Belly dance. Belly dance. No, I'm observing the breath. No, I didn't say to observe the breath. I asked you to observe the belly dance. Why? The belly moves with the breath. Okay? Why belly? Because belly is the center of energy. From here, the energy starts moving. Okay? Understand? So observe the belly dance, not the breath. Is it clear? Is it clear at all? Observe the belly dance, not the breath. So once you observe the belly dance, your mind becomes silent because you are observing the center of energy in our body. Are you clear? This much is clear to you? If the mind goes somewhere, starts drifting, then remember the breath. And remember that breath is saying soham. You don't have to chant also. Breath is saying soham. I am consciousness. So again, attention goes back to belly dance. Belly dance. Right? You are clear? Not lungi dance. Okay? So go back to the belly dance. So the moment you go back to the belly dance, the mind starts becoming silent because you are going to the center of energy. Please understand, this was your center of energy and your mother's stomach. Okay, where are you getting fed in? Now also the breath goes here, the food gets digested, it's a center of energy. The mind starts becoming silent naturally. If the mind drifts, become remember that breath, soham, come back. That's all. Okay, so is this steps clear? One more thing. What are you observing? The question again. What do you observe? You are not observing belly dance. You are observing the Shakti dance. The dance of Shakti. The movement of Shakti. Are you clear? So again, if you think the belly dance will come to the body consciousness, you have to remember it's a dance of Shakti. It's a movement of Shakti. Right? Shakti is in Shiva, consciousness. So what you are observing really is movement of consciousness. Clear? So if you start thinking that I am observing the movement of body, then the body related thoughts will come. Okay? It's like this, whichever domain you think of, that thoughts will come. If you are at home, the home related thoughts will come. If you are in the office, office related thoughts will come. If you are in body, body related thoughts will come. If you are consciousness, silence will come. Clear? So you have to understand, I am observing, I am consciousness, shivoham. Okay? I am consciousness, which is silence and peace. And I am observing a small movement in consciousness. That's all. It's not about belly, it is about consciousness. It's about Shakti. It's not about Shakti, it's movement in consciousness. Shiva is silence and Shakti is movement in consciousness. That's what you are observing. Is it clear? Now if you forget and drift, again come back to the belly dance. Again remember soham breath. Again remember Shakti. Again remember to consciousness. So you are again and again going back to consciousness. Right? Which means silence and peace, infinity. Are you clear? Any questions? So there are three movements are happening in the belly. One is outward movement and other is inward movement and pause. Okay. Outward, inward, pause. Three movements. Right? So what is the outward movement? The breath in. What is the inward movement? And what is the pause?
Silence.
Space between the two. Right? The inward movement is called life. The outward movement is called death. Sorry, outward movement is called life because breath is going in. Inward movement is called death. and pause is beyond life and death. Right? So what is the average age of human being? Anybody can tell me? Average age, how many years people will live? 75 years people live, which is false. He says 75 years people live. You agree or disagree?
Minus the past.
Disagree.
Living to the
age. Now what is your
My present age.
No, no. What is the age? What is the expected age of human beings average? He says 75. What's your idea?
One lifetime, you're saying, from the beginning.
No, no, not lifetime.
Your questions are always like that.
So, this lifetime.
This lifetime. About 60,
65 years. 65. She has reduced 10 years. Okay. Oh, somebody went out? Or? Okay. In reality, nobody lives up to 70 years, or 65 years, or 50 years. They live only one breath. So really what's happening is breath is going in, the body is becoming on. The breath is going out, the body is becoming off. On, off. On is called life and off is called death. What is it? Every moment?
The process.
No, you said the sentence clearly. Every moment? Every moment we are? See, he said we. How many are there in their head? How many people are there in your head? Every moment I die. So your I die is false because I don't die. The body dies. Body dying is not I dying. Okay? From the society point of view, body dying is you dying. This is the programming by the society. Okay, they say after 60 years person died, after 70 years person died. They are confusing Atma with the body.
I don't die. I don't die.
I don't die. And you only celebrated what is your how many years birthday?
90th.
90th years. So you only celebrated. So Atma has no birth, no death, no birthday, no birth, marriage anniversary also. So this is all from the society point of view. Society says, oh, this person died.
But Atma doesn't require any birthday. No birthday for Atma.
Correct. But then are you living that understanding? So the question is, these are all the teachings. But are you living the teachings or are you living in ignorance? Right?
Mostly
ignorant. So that this class is about reminding you what is reality. If you know Atma never dies, Atma is not born, I am Atma, why will you come here?
To know that.
To remove the ignorance. So the death is actually a false. Okay? So body is dying on and off every moment. You understand? Then what will happen after the 65 years? It's like a bulb. Bulb going on, off. Bulb on, off. In the Deepavali, you know, switch on, on, off, on, off, on, off. It's only the thing is, it's happening fast.
Then
bulb
goes.
At 65 years, the bulb is tired and blown up. So that is what society calls as death. But it has nothing to do with Atma. Okay? To say that he died also is false. Because he is consciousness, Atma. It's false. The body died. Body fused actually. But otherwise, body is dying and coming up every moment. Moment to moment. Moment to moment. Moment to moment. Are you clear? And between this moment, there's a gap. Okay? It's paused. Right? So what is there in the gap, Ashwini? On, Shakti has become life. Off, Shakti has become death. That's why Shakti is Kali, death. Okay? She is Gauri, life. Dance is happening. Life, death. Life, death, dance is happening. In between there is a gap. There is no dance. Pause. Shiva only is there. Okay? Now who is watching this dance? Shiva, Shakti's dance? Shiva, consciousness. Right? And once you start observing this, you become Shiva. Birthless, deathless, eternal. You are the observer, you are not the dancer. The Shakti makes you dance actually, the Jiva. Then you start, oh, I am dying, I am beloved. Okay? So this whole concept of death is false, bogus. There's nothing called death. Are you clear? So you start observing life and death of your body now. And beyond that gap. So this is exactly what happens after you die. Once you die at the age of 60, 70, the body is fused. Okay? Life, so what's happening is on, off. On, off is happening every minute. So at that life, at the time of death, on, off. On, off, off, off. Okay? The body is gone. Now, the Jiva has no, this not, this doesn't have this body. Then there is a pause. Pause is with Shiva. So then he wakes up in another body. That's all is happening. So your entire Punarjanma cycle you're observing in breath. Okay? So once you observe this, you become go beyond birth and death. Are we clear? Maitri? Is something else going on in between? Sri Ram? So life and death, life and death, life, death, beyond death. Life, death, in between life and death, life, death is what you are observing. Okay? Every moment body is dying, coming up. Body is dying and coming up. Is it clear? But you have a thinking and understanding that I am the body. So that's why you say I died at, that person died at the age of 60. You got it? Now, is this frightening? Dying every moment? Huh? Is it frightening?
No.
No. Why is it not frightening?
Because you are dying so often.
You practice a
bit. Huh?
It has become a practice.
Right? So, I mean, this concept of body dying moment to moment, does it change, alter your view of life? How?
I'm not scared of death.
You're not scared of death? Because you are the one who is observing that, okay? The one who observes birth and death of the body becomes free from birth and death. Okay? Trayambakam Yajamahe Sugandhim Pushtivardhanam Urvarukamiva Mratyor Mukshiya Pandana. You know, this is mantra which is actually is for liberation. People keep on repeatedly chanting the mantra without understanding. Trayambakam Yajamahe. Let me understand or know that Shiva, okay, who will free me from birth and death, like a pumpkin is cut from the
tree.
And understanding Shiva has to happen through Shakti, breath, moment to moment. This is the real meaning of Trayambakam Yajamahe mantra. Understand? Repeating mantra million times is not the solution. Understand, that's why his mantra is called Mananam Manana Trayati the mantra. Mantra has to be understood. The meaning has to be understood and internalized. Okay, now we have become very, very ritualistic and keep on practicing something without expressing essence. So understand Shiva. Who is Shiva? I am. Okay? So understand Shiva.